Bingo. Focus on that core.
Oh, now he remembers. Don't keep me waiting in suspense next time.
Take him down.
This is now. You're mine.
Sorry, guys. Sorry if everything glitching out, but YouTube didn't want to load this in. So.
Please welcome Tetsuya Nomura, director, Final Fantasy VII Remake.
I'll go check all the others to make sure they load it.
Thank you for joining us, Nomura-san. It is an absolute honor to have you here. Katase-san, how do you feel working with Nomura-san once again on Final Fantasy VII Remake?
はい、彼とはですね、原作のFF7以降、何作もね、一緒にね、その後も仕事はしてるんですけども、今作のね、再びね、ディレクションとキャラクターデザイナーとしてね、ストーリーとね、がっつり組むのはまた久しぶりなのでね、22年前と全く変わらない熱量でね、今作でも取り組んでる姿を見てね、私も正直ね、喜んでいます。
Since the original Final Fantasy VII, I've worked with him on many titles, but it has been a while since we've actually had him work so heavily on a project like this, from the direction to character design to the story. And I'm really happy to see him working on this title with the same passion that he had 22 years ago.
Nomura-san, comment,
please. Yes. I've been waiting for a long time, but I've always been supporting the fans. 本当にありがとうございました。そしてですね、皆さん今日初めてプレイ画面を結構長めに見たと思いますが、おそらく想像してたものとは少し違ったんじゃないかなと思っております。
So first and foremost, we wanted to extend our gratitude to those who have been waiting so patiently and have been supporting us for such a long time until now. And also, we've taken a look at gameplay right now, and we fairly showed you a good bit.
でですね、まあ、そういうわけなので、皆さんぜひ触れてみたいんじゃないかなと思いましてですね、実際に、触ってみたいですかね。
And I was wondering, do you guys want to actually play the game?
ということでですね、明日から開催されます E3 のですね、スクエアエニックスブースの方で、セブンリメイク、プレイアブル出展していますので、ぜひ機会のある方は、触れてみてください。
So we actually have playable demo kiosks available at the Square Enix E3 booth. So I hope you have the opportunity to try it out.
はい。それではですね、最後に、皆さんにご覧いただきたいものがありますので、ぜひ、昨日はですね、コンサートの方でショート版のトレーラーを公開しましたけども、今日はロング版をご用意してますので、ぜひご覧ください。
So finally, there is something that we wanted to show you. Yesterday we showed you a short version of a trailer at the Final Fantasy VII concert. But today we have a longer version.
それでは、
Again, guys, I'm sorry for the technical difficulties. I know the stream stopped once.That was because one of the deals would not stream. I'm sorry about that.
Appear to call themselves Avalanche Servant.
You can have it for saving my life. You think he's a keeper?
Oh my god. Y'all gotta look at the bigger picture here. Nothing worth fighting for was ever won without sacrifice.
Help me!
Have you been a good girl?
I heard you're having second thoughts.
I know we have to think big if we're going to make a difference. But not like this. I feel trapped. My turn.
Cloud, I have a favor to ask of you. Run away. You have to leave. You have to live.
You bastard! Yeah!
Hold on to that hatred.
Anyway, this is awesome, guys. I'm taking care of some technical difficulties in the background. That's why I haven't been talking or you haven't heard any audio. So. Anyway, I'll go away and see y'all into this next part now.
The son I wanted to see.
You keep your eyes closed.
I know what happened with you guys in Seattle.
Singing a strange tune.
How do you feel?
With us misfits.
Come on! Gotcha!
If you could just ready when you are, young master.
Oh my god, this is so exciting.
All of your fears.
Oh my gosh.
I love the setting, it's so beautiful, man.
Time to hit the road.
You'll be fine, Daniel. As long as we're together.
I want to see what his power can do.
Come on, Daniel. You got this.
Starting to be able to control his powers.
Oh, no.
No, I shouldn't do this.
Stop it, you crazy?
Jacksepticeye. That's crazy. They must have got early access.
Oh my god.
I don't even know what this is.
I miss Dad.
I'm so sorry, Daniel.
Actually, it might be
I'm
out.
Really glad I got to meet you.
It's the same for me.
I have no idea what this game
bro,
is.
Bro,
so
hug.
If
what
y'all
nice
know,
dude,
please
man.
Help me out.
It's the puppy!
The puppy!
We got a puppy!
Daniel!
Oh, this is gonna be the cliffhanger.
That's so sad!
God damn it.
Stop, Daniel. I said stop!
Don't grab me!
That was so intense.
It's my power, not yours.
What the?
No,
that's the ending, isn't it?
This game is awesome.
Long ago, miasma has blanketed the world. Crystals keep the deadly miasma in check, but the crystal's power is not
that eternal. Game was Life is Strange too, guys.
These are the chronicles of brave young adventurers who journey to protect their home. These are the Crystal Chronicles.
If we had no crystals, miasma would consume us all, correct?
Never did I imagine that it could be so bright. In online multiplayer mode, caravan with friends wherever they may be. Keep the adventure close at hand. The journey now unfolds on smartphones. Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles Remastered Edition. This winter, embark on a new journey once more.
This world is full of mysteries.
Prepare yourself! I will not lose to you!
Now the true lesson begins.
The hunt is on.
This is the beginning of your end.
Conjure lightning.
This will settle things.
My blade protects those in need.
Now seal the deal.
Let's end this, shall we?
My brand, I'll strike you down.
I'm ready for you.
This is our chance.
Octopath Traveler.
It's the one, the only, the builder's builder of a game! It's Dragon Quest Builders 2!
What in the world, ladies and gentlemen?
The children of Hargon, the vile cult that worships destruction,
has outlawed
the building, cooking, and creation of all things, and captured the builders! All hope seems to be lost until you! A young apprentice builder manages to escape the clutches of evil. Washed up on the deserted shores of the Isle of Awakening, and with the help of your spirited and mysterious companion, Malroth, it is up to you to doff your mallet and club, unravel the riddles of this land, and
this
defeat the hateful
weird.
Children of Harkon. Travel the diverse islands and discover your true potential as a master builder.
Yay!
There is a land of adventure with many islands offering unlimited building combinations. You will have to master new crafting skills on each island, with more to do and even more to create. Everything in Dragon Quest Builders 2 is much, much bigger! Build huge structures in a larger world with more variety and options than ever before. And with a little help from the eager islanders. The world is humongous, and you'll need your wits about you to get around. Run across open fields and explore ruins, treacherous mines, and spectacular castles. Dive into the watery depths to discover hidden treasures. Climb the highest mountains to catch the sunset. And glide home to rest up for your next day of adventure. But beware, monsters roam this land and will need to be dispatched with cunning composure. Luckily, accompanying you on your quest is the enigmatic Malroth, an aggressive amnesiac with a fondness for fighting foes. Use powerful attacks on the battlefield to take down monstrous beasts. Work together with your villagers to till soil, plant seeds, and raise a multitude of crops. Be sure to customize the way you build your fields to support the kind of crops you're growing. Harvest anything from the humble cabbage and wheat to tantalizingly tasty tomatoes. Big projects require big, big help. You and three friends can team up online to build anything you can imagine. Let your creativity run wild! The only limit is your imagination, so call on your friends and build your fate together!
build is paved with peril, young builder. Only you can defeat the children of Hargon. Bring an end to destruction and save the world in Dragon Quest Builders 2!
Just so you guys and girls know, the reason I'm not talking very much is because a lot of these games are out of my realm of expertise, so I really can't put much input into them.
Do not lose heart. Do not look back. Remember, you're the Luminary. We believe in you.
The Turing test I do know about, and that is a very difficult game. I believe me and Tyler had to cheat on it to be able to beat it. It is a very difficult game. Let's see if I know any more of these. That looked cool when I'm done plating. Battalion something. I think it was like 1944. But what's this?
Hello everyone, this is Carolina.
Alberto and Carlos Mastretta.
We're a family of motorsport fans from Mexico, and we're the founders of Original Fire Games.
Over the last few decades, we have seen a fascinating evolution in racing games. And nowadays, you can drive almost any type of car on amazing recreations of the best tracks in the world.
However, we believe it's time to try something different. We want to do this by reviving a style that pioneered racing games decades ago.
Our game mixes top-down racing with a classic, sharp, arcade look and tactile driving physics, which brings together a whole range of styles and eras of motorsport.
We are delighted to share this moment with you.
And show a sneak preview of our game, which Square Enix Collective will publish in 2020.
Join us for the ride, and see you again soon.
Wow, this is a unique style that you honestly I don't believe you see very much anymore. But I like that. Circuit Superstars. That looks awesome.
Battalion 1944 recaptures the core of classic competitive first-person shooters. You'll need to quickly coordinate strategies with your team on the fly, whilst keeping your movement nimble and your aim precise if you hope to beat out the competition. There are multiple game modes for you and your team to dive into. Test your skills in domination, capture the flag, or team deathmatch, and perfect your tactics in the highly competitive Wartide game mode. FaceIt's competitive toolset is fully integrated into the game, bringing world-renowned competitive matchmaking, 1v1s, tournaments, rankings, and leaderboards. Kill enemies, win matches, and rank up to demonstrate your Battalion 1944 prowess and unlock visual customization rewards. Each season will bring challenges for you to complete and medals to unlock, whilst tracking your in-game accomplishments and providing you with an easy way to compare them against your friends via in-game leaderboards. Halt the Axis offensive in their tracks with the Rapid Fire PPSH, or take fire with pixel precision with the Mosin Nagant, and a whole host of new weapons just as deadly as their owners. With a range of environments to test your skills in and a variety of weapons at your disposal, play as a team and compete to be top of the leaderboards. Available now on Steam.
Their music is now on streaming services. That is awesome. Because Final Fantasy has some good music. And that's just awesome, the way that commercial played out, too. That's hilarious. Hearts. What?
Please welcome Naoki Yoshida, producer and director, Final Fantasy XIV Online.
My name is Naoki Yoshida, producer and director of Final Fantasy XIV. 今日はですね、すみません、短い時間ですが、僕からはいよいよこの7月2日発売となる Final Fantasy XIV 拡張パッケージ第3弾、漆黒のヴィランズの紹介をさせていただきます。
So we'd like to take a little bit of your time to show off Shadowbringers Final Fantasy XIV's third expansion pack, which is releasing on July the 2nd.
2013年に新生オルゼア、あ、レルムリボーンが発売されてから、6年が経ちました、なんと世界で累計登録アカウント数1600万を突破し、なんとこのですね、漆黒のヴィランズの発売を前にして有料会員数も過去最高を、更新することができました、これらは全て世界中のプレイヤー、光の戦士の皆さんのおかげです。この場を借りて改めてお礼申し上げます。
It's been 6 years since the release of A Realm Reborn in 2013, and over the years we have surpassed 16 million total registered users. Plus, we have reached the highest number of active subscribers in history, in its history, before the launch of Shadowbringers. This is all thanks to our players, our Warriors of Light.
このシャドーブリンガーズではですね、拡張パッケージにとどまらない新作 RPG 一本分のボリュームと、そしてゲーム体験をお届けしたいと思います。
We view Shadowbringers as more than a simple expansion pack, but as a new game filled with volume and gameplay experiences that are comparable to a brand new standalone RPG title.
また新ジョブであるガンブレイカー、それから踊り子、新種族のロスガルとビエラなど、これからファイナルファンタジー14を始める皆さんにも多数の新規の要素が用意されています。
And there are so many new elements in the game for those who have yet to play Final Fantasy 14, including two new jobs, the Gunbreaker and the Dancer, as well as two new playable races, the Frothgar and the Viera.
ぜひファイナルファンタジーシリーズの最新作としてファイナルファンタジー7リメイクの発売、2020年3月3日までの間、漆黒のヴィランズをお楽しみください。
We are excited to bring Shadowbringers as the latest installment in the Final Fantasy franchise for our fans to enjoy, at least until 2020 March 3rd, when Final Fantasy 7 Remake comes out.
それでは、いよいよ7月2日、ローンチとなりますが、この場で世界初公開となるその漆黒のヴィランズのローンチトレーラーをご覧いただこうと思います。
We are pleased to bring a world premiere of the launch trailer for Shadowbringers releasing on July the 2nd.
Please take a look.
Well, if it ain't the oldest joke in the book. And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night? Over 100 bleeding years ago, that's when.
In that chaotic no man's land between realms, time and space warp and blend in unexpected ways. What Orianger saw was the future.
Senators came to be. They were once living creatures or people that were caught in the path of the flood. Once the change is wrought, there is no going back.
The eternal light of these creatures has confounded us for nigh on 100 years. For each we have put down, another has risen up in its place. Born of the self-same ether relinquished by its predecessor.
That's him. That's Vorthry.
Sin Eaters are part of Yulmor's society. But they must be fed with ether. Living ether. This world's beyond saving.
like those who try to save it. This world has had its fill of heroes. The star was made manifest.
I'm sorry, I can only assume I misheard, but it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Hydaelyn are not gods, but...
They are gods after a fashion, yes. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
That game has an awesome art style to it. I don't know too much about it, but it has an awesome art style. What in the world is this? Let's find out. I didn't know that was a Square Enix game. That looked familiar, but I didn't know that was a Square Enix game, so I didn't guess it. Where are we going to next? I just hope we get some more news about the Avengers. Thank you.
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. Enjoyed by fans the world over, has surpassed 39 million downloads. Now, Square Enix proudly presents the international reveal of a new title born from the FFBE universe. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. These two titles, FFBE and War of the Visions, will be the pillars of the growing world of Lapis. This is the story of Ardora, a continent of Lapis. A tiny spark here ignites the flames that would embroil the entire continent in conflict. A conflict later spoken of as the War of the Visions. Leonis, ruled by the Red Lion Monarch, possesses the power of visions, as well as twin princes. Horn, the great western kingdom, governed by a policy of peace and its brave and wise king. Fenris, where the king of the savages has organized the barbarian tribes into Ardora's mightiest militant state. Wezzet, the great eastern kingdom over which reigns its icy despot. Crystal Sanctum, a religious city-state with believers throughout Ardora, founded by one who claims to be God. Each burden with its own dignity, thus is the curtain drawn on a struggle in which the fate of nations rests. Is for one's homeland. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy, Brave Exvius. Now in development.
Not actual gameplay footage. I've never seen a game put that, but okay. I really love the Bulletstorm, so, and the Gears of War trilogy, so if this is anything close to what those were, it should be pretty good. Outriders. Nice.
Please welcome Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head, People Can Fly.
All right. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head at People Can Fly, the studio behind Bulletstorm and Gears of War Judgment. Yeah, any Bulletstorm fans in the house? All right. Wow, let me tell you, it feels great to be here and feels amazing to be able to finally announce Outriders. I'd like to thank the team at People Can Fly. You guys are amazing, and I know that some of you are watching this live, even though it's 4 a.m. in the morning in Poland, so Make a noise for them, please. Thank you.
Wow,
thank
that's you. Insane.
And of course,
that they're
Square Enix for the help and support as we work together on this exciting new IP. You know, over the past few years, People Can Fly has grown to over 200 developers and 4 studios across Poland, the UK, and most recently the US to bring you what is our most ambitious shooter to date. To present more of our vision, I would like to take this moment to introduce a short video from our game director, Bartek Mita. So thanks a lot. More on Outriders this winter. Thank you.
Shooters are in our DNA. It's our passion, and it's what we do. Outriders draws on all our experience from all our previous titles. It's a game we wanted to make for a very long time. We describe Outriders as a dark, modern shooter built with traditional values. By that, I mean we are creating an experience with a strong story that you can enjoy with your friends or on your own. We want to tell a complete story. We are confident we are building a shooter with a powerful gunplay, incredible weaponry, and a hostile new world we want to spend many hours in. It's a game we've had in our heads ever since People Can Fly left Epic Games. Outriders is a 1-2 or 3-player drop-in, drop-out co-op shooter. In our game, you will create your own Outrider and journey across the hostile planet of Enoch in search of the source of a mysterious signal. It's a pretty dark and unforgiving world, and yes, there is a lot more depth to the game, but I can't say too much more right now.
Sounds awesome. It really does. I can't wait to see more about it.
Reincarnation is the foundation of our way of life. We celebrate the lives we've been given and offer up prayers for the next. It is grief of death which shackles the living and causes the dead to stray. Indeed, there is no greater affront to reincarnation. So we turn our grief to joy as we send off the dead. But the souls of those who held back their tears in life still need salvation in death. A duty that falls to the Watchers. The Watchers sever the bonds that tie the lost to this world and send them off to the next. They navigate the emotions of the living and the dead. They prize life above all else. This is the story of one Watcher.
Another Final Fantasy game remastered. I didn't get to read the Roman numerals, so I'm not sure which one. But that's pretty cool for Final Fantasy games. Like I said, I've never really dove into these games very much, so I don't know about... I don't know much about the lore and the story and stuff like that. But they do have a really cool art direction. Yes, 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 the Avengers, guys. The Avengers. Let's go. Let's go, ladies.
The Avengers were everything I wanted.
Yes.
Hello, San Francisco.
Thor, Tony, check it out.
Try to keep up.
I will go away so we can enjoy this trailer and its goodness.
This just got a whole lot more interesting.
Call them murderers.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Well, we all lost something that day. But that's not how this story ends.
Please welcome Sean Eskai, Creative Director, Crystal Dynamics, and Bill Roseman, Vice President and Creative Director, Marvel Games.
Yeah.
Yes, 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 ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. We love you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. We are incredibly excited to reveal Marvel's Avengers to the world. A few years ago, Crystal Dynamics and Marvel began collaborating on an original Avengers game. One that combined epic action adventure with cinematic storytelling. A game where we as players can experience in both single player and co-op what it's like to be Earth's mightiest heroes.
Do I have any true believers in the house?
Yes!
Awesome. Because you will instantly recognize your favorite superheroes and villains, but you'll also see that they're unique to this game, as this is Crystal's interpretation of these iconic characters.
Our story begins at A-Day, as San Francisco celebrates the opening of the Avengers West Coast headquarters. And the team's custom helicarrier, outfitted with a strange experimental energy source. However, the day turns deadly when an attempt to steal this new technology results in massive destruction. Blamed for the tragedy, the Avengers are outlawed and our heroes disband.
5 years later, a horrific evil threatens the world, and our only hope is to reassemble Earth's mightiest heroes. You'll play as your favorite Avengers in an all-new original story showcasing authentic Marvel heroism and humanity. It's about losing what matters to you most and fighting to get it back.
Yeah! Yeah!
Most importantly, this is a story about self-acceptance in the face of adversity, about embracing our individual powers and learning that together we are mighty.
You'll lead the team as the legendary super soldier, Captain America. You'll call down the lightning as the Asgardian god of thunder, Thor. You'll channel the anger of scientist Bruce Banner by unleashing the Hulk.
Oh, yeah.
You'll gather intel and strike swiftly as the ultimate tactical spy, Black Widow.
Yes, please.
And finally, you'll blast through the sky as the charismatic Tony Stark, known to the wider world as the Armored Iron Man.
To bring this incredible story to life, we've assembled an all-star cast. I'll let them introduce themselves.
So, here we are. Avengers assembled.
Who are you people again?
Hi, I'm Troy Baker, and I play Bruce Banner.
Hi, I'm Jeff Shine, and I play Captain America.
Hi, I'm Travis Willingham, and I play Thor.
Hi, I'm Laura Bailey, and I'm playing Black Widow.
Hi, I'm Nolan North, and I play Tony Stark. There's certain characters I don't think you ever have to be talked into.
Yeah.
You know, so we'd like to have you play Tony Stark Iron Man. Yeah, yes. you know, everybody always portrays him as this super confident character, and I think it's a mask for him. I think he's one of the most vulnerable guys.
I think Bruce is just such a cool character. A lot of people are really quick to bring out the big green, but I think that Bruce is a super complex character. It's fun, and I've never played him before.
What is very relatable about Natasha is she's extremely capable, but she's at the core, she's human. She's surrounded by all of this larger than life stuff, and she has to step up to it.
I feel like Thor got really interesting in the last like 10 or 15 years. For me, I like where he's kind of landed in the public eye, you know.
One of the things I think is cool about Cap is I never feel like he necessarily wants to be a leader. He accepts that he is. I feel like sometimes the best leaders are the ones who don't necessarily want to be, but they're right for the job.
Having an original story to tell as well, what they've done at Crystal Dynamics is great, so I think everybody's going to be pretty stoked.
The Avengers are at their best when they are all together, but the chemistry is... Do not shake.
Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Can't wait for you to be able to play the game, but right now, you don't have to wait for some exclusive content.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Did you even check the science? Did you check?
It was a heist, Bruce.
No.
We were outsmarted.
No. The Terrigen reactor was unstable, and you knew that. You knew that, and you still paraded it before the entire world.
So what? We just give up?
We didn't give up, Tony. We failed. At least I can admit that. We failed him. We failed him.
Please welcome Scott Amos, head of studio, and Megan Marie, senior community and social media manager, Crystal Dynamics.
Hello, E3. You've just seen a high-level view of the cinematic and character-driven campaign of Marvel's Avengers. But launch is only the beginning of this adventure.
Marvel's Avengers delivers a narrative over multiple years, with exciting new content released at a regular basis.
Like the Avengers, you and your friends are stronger together. You'll assemble into teams of up to 4 players online where you can master extraordinary abilities, where you can customize a growing roster of heroes and defend the Earth from ever-escalating threats. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And to make sure everyone comes on this journey with us, we're incredibly thrilled to announce that every new superhero and every new region will be delivered at no additional cost. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
So our promise
yes.
to the community
yes.
is that yes. we won't have random loot yes. boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
Yeah. This game represents a collaboration across Crystal Dynamics, Marvel Games, I know you're out here. Eidos Montreal, these guys are here. Nixie Software. Our new Crystal Northwest studio. And everyone at Square Enix.
So our game is about embracing your powers and living your superhero dreams. We have an exclusive gameplay demo in our booth that will show you more of the core campaign, its original story, and our superheroes in action.
So, Marvel's Avengers will release worldwide on PS4, Xbox One, Stadia, and PC. We got you covered. And we're excited to be partnering with PlayStation to bring some awesome surprises to the PlayStation audience, including early beta access and unique benefits that we'll be revealing in the future. But before we go, we have one final glimpse into our world, including when you'll get to play this game. This is what's next for the Avengers. Thank you, true believers.
I have a plan, but it's risky.
Hank, that doesn't look ready.
Come on, Tony, live a little.
Unbelievable. It
worked.
It's sort of cute when they're small.
Ah, I didn't doubt you for a second, Hank.
Quite a few games coming out in 2020 that look excellent. And I believe that's going to end this conference, if I'm not mistaken. Yep, that ends it, guys, and I will see you all on Saturday for your regularly scheduled programming. Goodbye, guys. Have a good one. God bless you.